is Anathon. There is a wise virgin from among the number of the brood who went forth of the blooded lamb to meet Christ. Hallelujah. Good morning, all. For those of us on Facebook, I invite you once again to join us at Mass by entering the replies in the comment section. So let us begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With you, Spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who set St. Catherine of Siena on fire with divine love in her contemplation of the Lord's Passion and her service of your church, grant through her intercession that your people participating in the mystery of Christ might ever exalt in the revelation of his glory, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever.
Severe persecution of the church in Jerusalem, and all were scattered throughout the countryside of Judea and Samaria, except the apostles. Devout men buried Stephen, and made a loud lament over him. Saul, meanwhile, was trying to destroy the church. Entering house after house, and dragging out men and women, he handed them over for imprisonment. Now those who had been scattered went about preaching the word. Thus, Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out as many possessed people, and any paralyzed and crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. The word of the Lord. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Shout joyfully to God, all the earth. Sing praise to the glory of his name. Proclaim his glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous are your deeds.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all on earth worship and praise to you. Sing praise to your name. Come and see the works of God, his tremendous deeds among the children of Adam.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
He has changed the sea into dry land, through the river that passed on foot. Therefore, let us rejoice in him. He rules by his might
forever.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Everyone who believes in the Son has eternal life, and I shall reign.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowds, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. But I told you that although you have seen me, you do not believe. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it up on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, y'all. And good morning to y'all on Facebook and YouTube also. We live in difficult times, don't we? We live in very difficult times. Tornado watches that wake you up in the middle of the night, a few trees down. There's a little bit of violence we hear on the news all the time. And of course, we're in the midst of this virus thing, coronavirus. Difficult times, very difficult times. I noticed something very curious about church history. Difficult times, you see, history, the history of the church over all these centuries, it kind of ebbs and flows. You have your difficult times and other times that are a little bit more easy. Now, it's very curious about the difficult times. The Holy Spirit seems to do something. He raises up great saints for us. He raises up great saints. You hear that? He raises up great saints. In the midst of difficult times and darkness, God gives us a light. A light. A light to guide his church. A ray of hope to guide his church. St. Catherine of Siena, that's the saint who we're celebrating today. She is just one of these people. A guiding light, a great saint that God gave to us, that the Holy Spirit gave to us to guide the church. A tremendous saint. The 14th century, that's when St. Catherine of Siena lived. It was a very difficult time like ours. There was wars, there was scandal, there was a plague. As a matter of fact, St. Catherine of Siena herself was born during a plague. How about that? Born during a plague. She was the 23rd child of her mother. And you thought you had a lot of kids. 23rd children. I think she had a total of 25. You thought you had difficult children. St. Catherine of Siena, from a very early age, she spoke her mind. She wasn't nothing shy about her. She spoke her mind. And she told her parents at one point she wasn't going to get married. She was totally devoted to Christ himself. Devoted to him. As a matter of fact, it was something like a mystical marriage. I'm just saying, Catherine of Siena. Along the way, she picked up another little habit. A little habit. She would give away her family's clothing and food. Yeah, how about that for a child? She'd give away your food and clothing. Well, she took a lot of criticism from her family. But we know one thing. St. Catherine, she had a good heart. She had a good heart. You know, that's what counts. She would visit the poor in hospitals and in their homes, the poor and sick. She had a wonderful heart. As a matter of fact, which he yearned for was reform. Reform in the church. He urged people to confess their love for God, completely. That's what she wanted. She was also instrumental during this time. You would think the Pope was always in Rome. Not so. During this time, she urged the Pope to come back to Rome. She did that by walking, a young girl, walking from Siena, Italy, to Avignon, France. That's over a mountain range, by the way. That's how tenacious she was. See, she spoke her mind and she was tenacious. Tenacious for God. And she got the Pope to come back to Rome. She is absolutely amazing. Yet one thing you may notice about St. Catherine of Siena, of course she's a saint. She's a doctor of the church. She lived in difficult times. But there was one thing about her y'all might notice from this story. She didn't wither away. She didn't go into a room and hide with her faith and become a hermit. That was not St. Catherine of Siena at all. What St. Catherine did that is remarkable, she brought her faith out into the world amidst all the difficulties and problems, and she brought her faith into it. She negotiated peace between city-states in Italy. She brought her faith into the midst of society. We're tempted to retreat. St. Catherine did the opposite. She brought her faith straight into it. She is absolutely amazing. I think that we can only pray for her intercession to strengthen our faith and our tenacity for God. Amen. Knowing that God the Father wills the best for all people, we come to Him now with our needs and those of our neighbors. For Catholic missionaries, may God give them strength and courage. Let us pray to the Lord. For judges and all who work in law enforcement, may God, the perfect judge, bless them with the gifts of wisdom, justice, and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who bear the burdens of loneliness, infirmity, poverty, or lack of basic necessities, let us pray to the Lord. For children, may the Holy Spirit help them grow in grace and knowledge of God's saving power. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died, may Jesus accept them to Himself and bring them to everlasting life. Let us pray to the Lord. And for those prayers and petitions that, if you're on Facebook, you're welcome to type in the comment section, or those prayers that you hold within the silence of your hearts. Let us pray to the God of compassion, You will eternal life for all Your children here on earth. Listen to our prayers and grant what is best through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, through the earth working in the hand, will become for us bread. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through the vine and work of human hands, we will become our spiritual good. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, our good and good of all those who pray. Accept, O Lord, the saving sacrifice we offer in commemoration of St. Catherine, so that instructed by her teaching, we may give evermore fervent thanks to you, the one true God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with his spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end, we are holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he
who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna
in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was matured and entered willingly into his passion, took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, by your costly resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have known us worthy in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, strengthen up the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gregory, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever. this time where we usually receive communion, I'd like to invite you to pray to God with all your heart, your mind, and your soul, and receive that heart of spiritual communion. Let us pray. May the heavenly table at which we have been fed, O Lord, confer eternal life upon us, and even in this world nourish the life of St. Catherine. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I'll give y'all a final blessing with a relic of St. Catherine of Siena. May Almighty God